you can use the ServiceNow ODBC driver in Microsoft SQL Server as a linked server. This allows SQL Server to query tables on a ServiceNow instance directly via the ODBC driver. Here, we assume you've already installed Microsoft SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio, as well as the ServiceNow ODBC driver on the computer. This video demonstrates how to configure a SQL linked server with the ODBC driver. Click an item to go directly to that topic, or continue watching to cover all topics. We run the SQL Server Management Studio as administrator and connect to our server. We'll start by configuring the provider for ODBC drivers. Here, nested queries, level 0 only, and supports like operator should be selected, and we recommend running the third-party provider in out-of-process mode, that is, with the allow in-process checkbox cleared. Here's why. Running the provider in-process, which means within the same process as the SQL Server, can have a negative impact, such as causing the SQL Server process to crash. Okay. We right-click Linked Servers to add a new linked server. Here, we give our linked server a name. And for provider, we select the one for ODBC drivers. The product name is an identifier. We can use any appropriate value here. The data source must match a system data source defined in the ODBC Data Source Administrator System DSN tab. We have several data sources, but we'll use this one, which is our production instance. The URL for this instance appears here. If you have only one data source, no URL will appear here because the URL is taken from the ServiceNow IP parameters in the ServiceNow ODBC Manager. We type in our data source, exactly as it appears in the ODBC Data Source Administrator. For security configuration, we specify that connections will be made using this security context. And here, we enter the username and password for a user account existing on the ServiceNow instance we've chosen as our data source. This user account must have the proper roles, for example, SOAP query, as well as another role, such as ITIL, that provides read access to the tables we intend to query. The credentials entered here must be those used to connect to the instance, not Active Directory credentials. If you have multiple ServiceNow instances set up as data sources in your ODBC Data Source Administrator, make sure the credentials you enter here are correct for the selected data source, located at the specified URL. Okay, we're all set. If you get an error message at this point, it may be because you did not configure the provider first. Go back and do that, and then add the linked server. We didn't get an error, so we're good to go. Now we check to see if our linked server can connect to the instance. And it succeeded. If you get an error here instead of a successful connection, it may be because the bit level of your installed ODBC driver does not match that of the application, which in this case is the SQL Server. Just uninstall the driver and install the one with the appropriate bit level. If you need help determining the bit level of your SQL Server, check out the Microsoft support article listed in the description of this video. Now, let's run a test query. To save time and space, we'll just ask for the short description from a single incident, which we know exists on our ServiceNow instance because we looked it up earlier. Darn, we got an error message, 7399 access denied. If you don't get an error here, rejoice, your linked server is working. Message 7399 is a Microsoft error that's unrelated to ServiceNow, but common in environments where the linked server is running in out-of-process mode, that is, with the allow in-process checkbox cleared, as we recommended earlier. If you get a 7399 error, don't panic. We'll walk you through the steps to resolve it in the follow-on video, Troubleshooting Microsoft SQL Linked Server Permissions Running Out of Process. If you encounter an error other than 7399, check out this KB article in HI, which provides links to Microsoft articles that may be helpful. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.